this lecture, we're going to be talking about universal quantifiers and existential quantifiers. Now, quantification is actually a rather complex concept to understand. And so this is going to take a lot of time to wrap your mind around. Although, luckily for us, we're not going to be dealing with quantification that much throughout this course. So if you do struggle, that doesn't necessarily mean you shouldn't move on. Hey everyone, real quick, I just want to mention that this video is a part of a whole course that I made. You can find a link to this entire course in the description below and make sure to click on that subscribe button. All right, let's take a look at what quantification is first. The existential quantifier is, and that's a backwards E, that means there exists or there is. So for example, there is an X such that X is less than zero. Asserts that there is a number less than zero. So this, what you're looking at, is a statement. That right there is a statement, and in fact, it's true. Why? Well, negative one. Negative one is less than zero. And so there exists an X such that X is less than zero. To prove these statements, all you have to do is come up with an X that satisfies the statement that you're trying to prove. And so that's pretty nice. That's existential quantifiers. The universal quantifier, which is an upside down A, and forgive the notation, it's a little confusing and annoying. It's read for all or every. For example, for all X, X is greater than or equal to zero. Now, this asserts that every number is greater than or equal to zero. Now, it's important to understand that when you quantify, it's important to quantify over a set. And so this X here belongs to a universe, and it's always important to describe what that universe is. So sometimes you'll see me write U equals the natural numbers, meaning that the natural numbers is the universe that we're working in which case this statement is actually a true statement. Every element in my universe is at least zero. That's true. Although if we were working over the real numbers, this statement would be false. And so it's actually really important to clarify what the universe is, but just assume that if I don't clarify, then we're talking about the natural numbers. All right, that being said, that is quantification. As with all mathematical statements, we would like to decide whether quantified statements are true or false. Consider the statement, for all x, there exists a y such that y is less than x. Is this true? Well, the answer depends on what our domain of discourse is, or our universe. When we say for all x, do we mean all positive integers, or all real numbers, or all elements of some other set? Usually this information is implied. Especially in discrete mathematics, we almost always quantify over the natural numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So let's take that for our domain of discourse here. For the statement to be true, we need it to be the case that no matter what natural number you pick here for x, for every x that you pick, there is some y that you can find where that y is less than the x that you picked. And so perhaps we can always choose that y is x minus 1. Whatever x you give me, I'll just throw you x minus 1, and I'll show you that for every x you throw at me, the y that I give you, which is x minus 1, is going to be less than that number. But here's the problem. What about x equals 0? What if you give me x equals 0? The statement should work for all x, that it's the natural number, and 0 is a natural number, so I would pick y to be x minus 1, which is negative 1. Well, that's not a number. Remember, in our domain of discourse, which is n here, negative 1 is not a number. Thus, we see that the statement is false because there is a number which is less than or equal to all other numbers. In symbols, that means that there exists an x such that for all y, x is less than or equal to y. Or actually, I'm going to write it like y is greater than or equal to x. Same exact statement, I just flipped it, and there's a reason I'm going to explain why I did that. So to show that the original statement is false, we proved that the negation was true. There is an x, namely x equals 0, such that for all y, y has to be at least that number 0, which is true in the natural numbers. 0 is, in fact, the smallest element in the natural numbers. So notice how the negation and the original statement compare. I'll draw the original statement. For all x, there exists a y such that y is less than x. Now you'll see why I wrote it like this here. How do these two things compare? Well, they're negations of each other. In the next video, we'll discuss in more detail how negation and quantifiers play together. Anyways, thanks everyone, and I'll see you in the next lecture.